avoid the friction, and for many other reasons also. There are two kind of liquids which are filled in the eye, filled in the sense they are present in the eye. So here, you know, here one very watery liquid is there, and this is known as aqueous humor. Okay, this is known as aqueous humor, and this is very watery kind of liquid. Now here, this technically aqueous humor is present here, like in the front part of the eye, near the pupil and all this kind, this area. Now behind the lens, you know, between the lens, I should say, between the lens and the retina, one little jelly kind of structure is filled. Okay, jelly kind of liquid is filled, which is known as vitreous humor. So this structure, this liquid is filled, is present over here. So there are, you know, along with all this thing, there are two kind of liquids also which are present. One is very watery. This watery liquid is known as aqueous humor. It is present in the front part of the eye, in the pupil area. Behind the lens is the little jelly kind of liquid, which is which is known as vitreous humor. Right now, so we were discussing about the power of accommodation, children. What is the meaning of power of accommodation? That means our eye has an ability to see the far, the distant object also, the object which is kept at long distance, and even, you know, we can read also. We can read from the book which we keep very close. That means we can see the distant objects also, and we the distance which are known, which are very far from us. And at the same time, we can read those. We can read or we can see the objects which are very close to our eye also. So this ability of the of an eye, this ability of the human eye to see the distant object also as well as a nearby object also is known as the power of accommodation. So what is this ability of the human eye? I'm emphasizing more on human eye because we are studying human eye over here. So ability of the human eye to focus, okay, or to see whatever you want to write. I will write in a simpler way, to see the distant as well as nearby objects also. And this ability to see the distant object also and the nearby object also is known as power of accommodation. Now, when we talk about like how far can a human eye can see, so this distance, you know, is known as far point. That means how far can we see. So there is, you know, for human eye, this distance is infinity. Okay, why it is infinity, children? Because sky, sun, stars, these all have a huge, there's a huge distance between these all objects, things, and between us. Between, like, are you getting my point? Like, these are very distant objects. These are very far away from us. So that is the thing, that we can see objects which are very far from us. And so this far point is known as infinity. Like, far point is not known as infinity, like far point is infinity. That means we can see, you know, a normal eye can see long distance after long distance, like long distances also, isn't it? Now the near point, like how near, if the object is placed, will it be possible to see for a normal human eye? So if I want to read a textbook, if I want to read something, and if I keep it very close over here, so if you want to read something, if you keep a textbook or a book or anything very close to your eye, just try it. Will you be able to read it? You won't be able to read it. So that minimum distance, see, what is far point? The maximum distance which a human eye can see, right? This is the maximum distance. Right, this is maximum distance which the human eye can see, and this maximum distance is infinity. We can see, you know, a human, normal human eye can see far placed objects also. When we talk about the near point, like how close an object can be, if you want to read it properly, so it can be not less than 25 centimeter. That means the if you want to read the textbook, it should be placed at least at 25 centimeter from your eyes, not less than that, or else you won't be able to read it, right? So why is it? So why is it? And you know, we were also discussing about the how this lens changes its shape. We can say the converging power changes, or we can even say the focal length changes. And due to the change in the focal length of the lens, the distant objects can be seen and the nearby objects can also be seen. How these both can be seen? By the change, by changing, by the change in what? The focal length, right? When the focal length changes, and the, or we can say the converging power also, you know, get changed. And so the lens become thin or thin. Lens become thin or thick. And so we are able to see the distant objects or the nearby objects and the distant objects. So what actually is happening is, children, so now there is no place left. I'll be writing over here only. Is it visible? Yeah. So what actually is happening, children? I'll just try to write over here. And here. So when we are focusing, when we are seeing the distant objects, right? When we are seeing the objects which are very far, so we are seeing distant object, right? When we are seeing distant object, so what is happening? Our ciliary muscles, these muscles are relaxed. Okay. So when we are seeing distant object, so ciliary muscles are relaxed. They are relaxed. Now, when these ciliary muscles are relaxed, so when they are relaxed, so they are pulling the suspensory ligaments tightly. Okay. So what is happening when we are seeing, when we are focusing on distant objects? So ciliary muscles are relaxed, and that is the reason these ciliary muscles are pulling the suspensory ligaments, right? So they are pulling these suspensory ligaments very tightly. Ligaments tightly. Right? So suspensory ligaments are pulled very tightly, and when the suspensory ligaments are pulled very tightly, so what is happening here? So the lens becomes thin. So lens becomes thin. That means it becomes less convex. It becomes less convex. Right? In this kind, are you all getting my point? We are focusing, we are seeing, we are observing the objects which are very far. In this situation, the ciliary muscles are quite relaxed, and so when they are relaxed, so this get stretched. Suspensory ligaments get stretched. When ciliary muscles are relaxed, so suspensory ligaments get stretched. And when you know what is happening, see, this is a lens and it is pulled from both the sides. Something is pulled, so it is going to what is going to happen? It's going to become thinner, isn't it? So it is going to become thinner, that means less convex. In this condition, what is happening, children? The focal length, it will have large focal, I'm not able to write now here, it will have large focal length, but it will have small converging power. It will have small converging power. And so we will be able to see the distant objects, and vice versa. Now what will happen when we are focusing, when we are trying to see the nearby objects? Now what will happen? This which were relaxed, it will become little, you know, it will become little loose, okay? And this tightness will also become, you know, it won't be so tight, it will become loose. And so it will come to, you know, it will become little thicker, right? And in this case, just opposite thing will happen, that focal, you know, the lens will become thicker, it will become more convex, and the focal length will become small, okay? The focal length will become small and the converging power will become more. That means it can focus, see, it becomes shorter, and then it becomes possible for us to see the nearby objects. That is the reason when we when I'm saying like we cannot see less, you know, we cannot read a textbook when it is nearby to, it is more closer than 25 centimeters. So what is happening here? The eyes has, you know, eyes are at the maximum accommodation level. It has become it has reached to the maximum thickest. Are you getting my point? When the book which we are trying to read is at less, you know, or it is at 25 centimeter, here the lens is at maximum you know thickness. It cannot, the eye cannot you know make it more looser, cannot make it more thicker. And so if we try to read the book which is kept at, you know, less than 25 centimeter, we won't be able to read it properly. Hope you all have understood this thing. So we'll just revise it very nicely, very quickly now. See, this is, we are talking about the structure of the eye. Now this outer part is bulgy part, it is known as cornea. The you know, whatever light which comes from the, enters into eye, comes from the cornea. And after this is the eyelid which closes the eye, you know, which covers the eye, I should say. When we close the, you know, eyelids, so the light cannot enter into the eye. As the cameras has got the shutter, when the shutter is closed, the eye, the light cannot reach the camera and cannot go inside the camera, I mean to say. Now this is the bulgy part, which is known as cornea. The first convergence of the light takes place here only. This iris is here, which is flat ring like, you know, membrane structure which is colored. It can also be known as diaphragm. Then here you know, lens is here. This lens is convex lens. It is soft, it is transparent. I have not written transparent. I have not written, so I'll just write here transparent also, right? So this lens is transparent, soft, flexible. It is made up of protein like protein, you know, it is made up of protein which is jelly like. Now this here, how it is attached, how it is stable at one place. So ciliary muscles are there. Ciliary muscles are attached, you know, these are the ciliary muscles. Here we have got suspensory ligaments. Now from one end the suspensory ligaments are attached to the lens, and from the other end they are attached to the ciliary muscles. Now here we have got one liquid, watery liquid filled, which is known as aqueous humor. Here one, you know, behind the lens is the membrane which is known as retina. Here the image formation takes place. Here one nerve is there which is related to eye. It is connected to the eye, so it is known as optic. And nerve means nerve. It is optic nerve. One spot where this optic nerve leaves the eye is known as blind spot. This membrane is a membrane where the image formation takes place. If we talk about the camera, the image formation takes place on the photographic film. Now this is the retina. Here the image formation takes place. Now this lens is convex. First convergence of the light takes place over here, which this cornea is also convex. The second and the rear and the not real, the final convergence of the light takes place here by the convex lens. Now this image formation, when we are talking about the image formation, the image which will be formed will be real and inverted because the convex lens is present here. Right, now the retina has got two different kinds of cells which are known as rods and cones. Rods rod shape, cones cone shape. Rods are deemed, you know, they become activated, they get activated, they become active, I should say, they become active in presence of dim light, and the cones become active in presence of bright light. And you know, the nocturnal animals has got more of rods in their eyes than us. And that is the reason they are able to see at night also. Now, when the image formation takes place over here, what actually is happening? These cells become activated. They, you know, the electrical signals are formed. These electrical signals from the retina, you know, retina through optic nerve, okay, through optic nerve, through optic nerve, it is going to be transmitted to the brain, and brain is going to, you know, interpret this as vision, and the you know, this erect image will be formed over there. After this we have discussed about, like, you know, what is far point and near point. Far point is the maximum distance which we can see with a normal eye, and that is infinity for human eye. The minimum distance with which we can, you know, the, you know, 25 centimeter if the distance is less than 25 centimeter, we won't be able to read. Now, iris is the one which adjusts the pupil size. Iris is responsible for the contraction and relaxation of the pupil. Now, what is pupil? Pupil is the gap between this iris. It is a hole, I should say, between the iris. Isn't it? So, when more light is coming into the iris, so what will happen? This iris will come little, you know, it will make the pupil, this hole, it will, they, this part will come closer and this hole will become little smaller. So, that more light is coming. So, when this hole becomes smaller, so the lesser light will enter into eye. When we are in dark, so what will happen? This pupil, this gap will increase, so that what will happen? The more light can enter into eye. So, iris is responsible for the size of the pupil, the contraction and the relaxation of the pupil. Now, after this, we have also discussed like what is power of accommodation. So, power of accommodation is the ability of the human eye to see the distant objects as well as the nearby objects also. Now, after this, we have discussed like how, you know, what is actually happening, how do we, like how are we able to see the distant objects as well as the nearby objects all together. So, it is because of the change which is coming in the size of the the thickness of the lens. When we are seeing the distant objects, so what is happening? The lens becomes little less, like it becomes thinner, it becomes little less convex, okay. And when we see the nearby objects, it becomes thick, it becomes more convex. So, this is how we are able to see the things around us, this beautiful world, okay. Now, we'll talk about, this all what we are discussing about is about the normal eye's vision, like this all is happening in the normal eye. Now, we need to also know about like what is happening when the person suffers from certain kind of diseases, like which kind of diseases we'll be discussing about. Maybe, we'll be discussing about the myopia and the hypermetropia. That means we'll be discussing now actually. So, there can be two conditions: when the person can see nearby objects and when the cannot see the far objects, vice versa. When the person can see far, the objects which are very far, they can, like it can be seen by the person very clearly, but is not able to read the textbook which is very close. And the third thing, even the person may have problem related to both the things, is not able to see the nearby objects also, is not able to read the textbook at the same time, he is not able to see the far objects also. So, what has to be done? And along with this, there are certain other diseases like cataract and presbyopia. So, we are going to talk about all these diseases now. So, this all what we have discussed is about the normal eye, the structure of the normal eye we have discussed, the working of the normal eye, for 8th standard, this all was there which we need to know, and the detailing will be done in the 10th standard. Then you will be able to understand the perfect, the eye actually works in a better way. So, now that's all with the structure of the eye. Now, we'll talk about the different diseases of the eye.